Hi everyone, Jared here from Email Experts, and in this video, I'm going to go over how to utilize email marketing to run successful competitions, grow your email list, and get more people to be engaged with your brand. If this is your first time on our channel, we are Email Experts. We help brands grow via email and automated marketing, and I would really appreciate if you could help smash the like button below. It will really help our channel out with the YouTube algorithm and help brands like you find our channel in the future. So why is list growth important? Building and growing your own email list is the best and only way brands should gain subscribers, as this will ensure they will be sending emails to people who want to hear from them in the first place. Brands that grow their own lists have a direct relationship with their customers having consented to being contacted, and the brand can then contact them with messages relevant to them. This boosts the sender's reputation and customers' willingness to open your brand's emails. On the other hand, brands that purchase lists, for example, people who don't give specific permission for the brand to send them emails in the first place, are not only taking on legal risks, but they also significantly increase the likelihood of their emails being marked as spam. Consequently, open rates and deliverability will be low, and conversion measures will be highly inaccurate. So now let's talk about competitions. Brands can use incentives to organically encourage people to sign up to their lists, such as discounts, ebooks, webinars, and newsletters. Competitions are also a great strategy for list growth that can be used alongside these organic methods. Competitions get people excited about your brand and further incentivize them to sign up, if you do it right. So before you set up your competition, you need to have a good strategy. First, you need to set up the right incentive, something that will encourage your audience to subscribe. Remember that the goal is to acquire new subscribers who are likely to become paying customers in the future. Every brand may offer different incentives depending on the target audience, the campaign, and the value proposition. The incentive should be relevant and beneficial in order to appeal to customers. So choosing the right competition price is paramount. Prices must be so compelling that it makes no sense not to sign up in the eyes of the potential customer. On the other hand, it is also important that the price is relevant to your brand to attract customers and not serial competition entrants. For example, if you are a fashion label selling female clothes and accessories, don't just offer a cash price, but instead offer something like a $500 new wardrobe. Offering product is always a good idea. That way, you are ensuring that people who sign up for the competition are relevant to your store and may become paying customers. One very important thing to note though is to never offer an iPad. Why? Because everyone wants an iPad. So if you offer an iPad as a competition price, even if you're an electronic store, you may get a huge spike in list growth and competition signups, only to find that the audience is completely irrelevant to your niche and they will never become paying customers down the line. Eventually, this will drag down your engagement numbers. Moving on, keeping in mind that the goal is to grow your customer base, at Email Experts, we recommend that brands nurture their subscribers as soon as they enter the competition and not wait for the competition to be over. Many subscribers may have just learned about your brand and they are especially receptive right after they sign up. Okay, so now let's just jump into Klaviyo to show you how you can trigger a nurture series from a competition. Just note that you can use any other email tools such as MailChimp or OmniSend, but just make sure that they have fraud detection since competitions can attract a huge number of fraudulent and bot email addresses, especially if you're offering a very attractive price. So in our example, we use Klaviyo and other competition apps. Let's jump right in. So for most of our clients, we normally recommend using these two apps to run the competitions, either Gleam Competitions or Viralsweep. These are two apps that we like to use in order to run successful competitions. Let me show you a quick example of how Viralsweep looks like. So as you can see, this is how Viralsweep works. You just have to embed their widget, their Viralsweep widget, on your page to run your competition. So it incentivizes them to leave their first name, last name, and email address in return to standing a chance to win a prize of your choice, therefore growing your email list effectively. They are very strong apps, but one thing to note though is that they are not free. They cost from $49 a month. So don't worry, later on in this video, we'll also go through a free method on how you can do it within Klaviyo itself. So now in Klaviyo, what we're going to do is to firstly create a list so that you can connect your list to the app. So I've just created this list called competition signups, And what you want to do, firstly, is to connect Klaviyo and Viralsweep. And how to do that? Firstly, you need to create an API code. So open up your settings. So it's under your account, under account settings. Just navigate your way to the API keys under settings. So what you want to do is to first create an API key within Klaviyo itself. Doesn't take long. And a handy tip is like I like to name or label my API key so I know which API key is used for which. So I'm just going to call this Viralsweeps. Okay, because we are using our dummy account, we don't have a paid Viralsweep account for this example. So I'm just going to go through how to connect it with Viralsweep's integration doc. So once you have a paid account with Viralsweep, you should have a connect email service option. And under connect email service, what you want to do is you want to navigate your way and click on Klaviyo or whatever other email marketing providers of your choice. So once you're there, it will prompt you to paste your Klaviyo API key. So you've just created them under your Klaviyo settings. So just copy and paste this long code. This is your private API key. If they ask for your public API key, your public key will be this. So just copy and paste this whole thing. Paste it within your Viralsweep API key box. Click connect. And then it will prompt a few lists for you to choose from, to choose which list you want to connect your competitions to. So then you can choose your list, which will be the list that we just created. Called the competition sign up list. That's why I named it. You can choose to name it however other way you choose to name your list. Right. And then once you're connected, you're good to go and you can connect. Now you can connect your list to trigger off a flow, a nurture flow that will nurture people who just sign up to your competitions. So before we get into that, I just want to show you a quick method on how I would do it if I want to do a free method, considering I don't have a paid Viralsweep account for my dummy account. So what we can do now is I can go on sign up forms here in Klaviyo. I can create a sign up form. So let's just use this one for now. And in Klaviyo itself, it asks you which list do you want to connect it to. Just note this is just the free method for those of you who don't want to use the Viralsweep method. Again, the Viralsweep method is the recommended method at email experts. But for those of you who don't have or don't want to pay for an account, this is how to do it within Klaviyo itself. So choose the list that you want to connect it to. I'll choose competition signups. I'll create the form. And now I have a form here. I can go ahead and add other inputs such as my first name and last name, but you can edit it however you wish. But now what you want to do is to turn this form live and embed the code on a page within Shopify itself. So I'm going to copy the embed code, go ahead and publish my form. And now what you want to do is to jump into Shopify and to just create a page. Like to create a page, I named it competition page as a placeholder. Normally, if you have a Viralsweep account, you will copy and paste your Viralsweep widget embed code and paste it on your page. Since I don't, I'm going to paste my Klaviyo one. So create a page, name it whatever, put in your competition details, and you just want to paste your you want to toggle this HTML editor and just paste your embed code over there. Go ahead and save, and now I'm going to publish my page. Yep, page has been published. So now I'm going to go and view it on my online store. And there you go. As you can see, the competition page loaded and our embedded form has appeared. If you have embedded your Viralsweep widget, your widget will appear here instead of this Klaviyo form. So now what you want to do is to test to see whether this form works. So the last thing you want to do is to run a competition, spend paid traffic to get to your website and realize that the form is not working, right? So what I want to do is I just want to put in an email address to test. I'm going to blur this out.
And I'm going to click sign up. And so within Klaviyo, you can change your thank you messaging. And within your Viralsweep or Gleam app, you can just change on how the widget appears. So now what you want to do is to see whether it actually works and whether it's fed through your list. So now what I want to do is to go to my list, competition signups. And as you can see, there you go. My email address is here. So now we know that the form works. Now what we want to do is now we can use this list to trigger a nurture series to nurture your competition subscribers, right? So what we want to do now is to go into flows. And I'm going to create a new flow. I normally tend to create from scratch. And let's just call this competition nurture series. And why do we want to have a nurture series? As mentioned earlier in this video, people who just signed up to your competition, they might have just heard of your brand and they are more inclined to being receptive to your emails once they are newly subscribed, as opposed to if you wait 30 days for your competition to end, 30 days later, and if you start sending them emails, then they might not remember your brand anymore. So it's good to nurture them right off the bat. So now as you can see, I just created a new competition nurture series and I want to choose the trigger to be triggered by the competition signups list. And there you go. So that's how you set up a competition nurture series. So how you build on your emails, this is what we recommend in Email Experts. So this should be the flow. So right off the bat, you should deliver your welcome offer. Almost immediately after they sign up. This is just to deliver the special offer to them and thanking them for signing up. You can choose, you can offer them a special offer such as a discount, percentage discount, or a free shipping code to incentivize them to make their first purchase anyway. And one thing to make sure is just to make things make the messaging consistent from your competition form. So if they sign up from the competition, make sure in the first email you say something along the lines of, thank you for subscribing to our competition, here's a special code for you anyway. The next email you should send probably a day or two later, this should be focusing around your brand or your founder story. So you can share your brand story, why your brand started, what's your company's values. And the goal here is to really build trust between yourself, the brand, and your potential customers. Next email, a couple of days later, you want to offer them an offer reminder. And this email is only sent to them if they have not purchased yet in the last 3 days. The goal of this email is to remind them that they have a 10% code or a free shipping offer and to really drive scarcity and urgency for them to use the code to make their first purchase. Wait another few days. The fourth email you want to send of this list should be a reviews email or an email showcasing your featured products. Basically to build trust with social proof, by sending reviews and to showcase your best sellers. Lastly, about 5 days after the initial email, you want to send them a final offer reminder saying, hey, this is the last email. Your special code will be expiring soon. Use it now. The goal of this email, again, is to drive scarcity and urgency, and it's optional for you. You can also include a countdown to further boost the urgency.
And there you have it. How to run successful competitions, how to grow your email list, and get people to be more engaged with your brand by connecting the two. My name is Jared. We help brands grow through email and automated marketing. We release videos every fortnight, so smash the like button, smash the subscribe button, so you can be notified the next time we upload a video. Thank you very much, and if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments, and we hope to make them into a video soon.